But not only the biology in ports has been investigated. Another pioneering activity of BALMAS is the assessment of chemical compounds in port environments that can be associated with ballast waters treatment technologies. Ballast waters can also contain chemical substances that are hazardous for the marine ecosystems. Our interest concerned the products of disinfection for the treatment of ballast water and anti-fouling paints used in the tanks of ships. Ballast water management systems make use of active substances on board in order to minimize the transfer of harmful aquatic organisms and pathogens. The majority of the traditional biocides are oxidant agents that, reacting with the organic matter in seawater, produce disinfection byproducts which are likely to be toxic to the aquatic environment. In the database developed by the IMO-GESAMP, Ballast Water Working Group, chemicals most commonly associated with the treated ballast water are haloacetic acids, trihalomethanes, haloacetonitriles. Moreover, there is a clear potential to discharge through ballast waters other chemical products, including organotins compounds, into the sea. It was demonstrated that the vector of worldwide transportation of TBT is not limited to hull and other exterior portions of ships, but also ballast water may act as a vector of much greater capacity and contribute to the rebuildup of TBT contamination in estuaries, international seaports, and coastal regions. We have analyzed water and the sediments, and for analysis of biota, we use the methodology of muscle watch. This considers the transplantation of mussels from uncontaminated areas to the investigation sites. In order to assess chemical contamination in selected ports of the Adriatic Sea, a baseline survey based on the active muscle watch activity, supported by water and sediment analysis, has been carried out. Seven ports have been chosen for the investigation: Bari, Ancona, Rijeka, Durres, Koper, Split, and Bar. So far, very few ships have ballast water treatment systems installed on board worldwide, and none of the ships investigated in BALMAS had treatment systems on board. This enabled us to truly assess the chemical baseline in our ports with respect to ballast water-associated compounds. Subsequent monitoring will verify if there will be a buildup in the concentration of such substances once the IMO convention enters into force and ships are required to have ballast water treatment systems on board.